A bison is an animal that is native to North America. While we sometimes refer to this animal as a buffalo, buffalo are actually slightly different animals that live on other continents. They are related to the bison, but not the same. There are both woods bison and plains bison. Today, we are talking about the plains bison. Bison are the largest land animal in North America. They can be over 6 feet tall and 10 feet long and weigh 2,000 pounds. Bison have short horns and short legs, but they can still run fast and have the endurance to outrun a horse. Bison have a shaggy, furry brown coat that keeps them warm in the wintertime and is shed in the summer. Long ago, there were millions of bison on the Great Plains. Herds could be 50 miles long. The ground would rumble when they passed. Plains Indian tribes such as the Blackfoot, Cheyenne, Comanche, and Sioux relied on the bison for their survival. They hunted bison with spears and bows and arrows. Sometimes animals were driven off cliffs or boxed into a canyon. Horses made hunting easier, as did the later introduction of guns. Native people ate the bison meat, but that wasn't everything they used. Every piece of the animal was used for something in their lives. The bison hide with the fur still on was used for warm blankets, for coats, for fur-lined mittens and shoes, and for rugs for teepee floors. Without the fur, the untanned hide could be used for things like drums or shoes, shields, and rope. The hide that was tanned to make it softer could be used for clothing. To tan the hide and make it softer, Native Americans used the bison's brains, rubbing it into the hide to create the desired effect. The hair of the bison was also used separately from the skin. That soft fleece that they have could be used to stuff things like dolls and pillows. Other hair from the animal could be used in jewelry or in making ropes. The bison's tail could be made into a whip or a fly swatter, or used for decoration. The short horns of the bison were also useful. They could be made into spoons or containers and used to adorn headdresses. Likewise, the bison's hooves were made useful, turned into rattles, wind chimes, and glue. Inside the mouth of a bison could be found teeth that were turned into jewelry, and a tongue that could be dried and turned into a comb. The organs of the bison were also useful. The empty bladders and stomachs could be turned into waterproof containers. The fat from the animal was used to make soap. Bones became tools or weapons, or could be made into carvings. Fibrous sinew from the animal was used to lash spear and arrowheads to the shaft and turned into bowstrings. And these are just a few of the ways that the native tribes made use of the bison. Much of their daily lives were impacted in some way by this animal. It is a little surprise that the bison held spiritual significance to some of these tribes, who would revere the animal and had tribal myths surrounding its relationship to people. The arrival of the Europeans changed everything. The newcomers overhunted the bison, built fences where bison had once roamed free. They brought in workers to create railroads who needed to be fed and saw bison as an easy source of food. When the railroads were finished, the trains brought in hunters who shot the animals in the thousands just for sport. The men in this picture are posing on a mountain of bison skulls. During what's known as the American Indian Wars, the U.S. government ordered their soldiers to deliberately kill bison as a war tactic to disrupt the lives and cause food shortages in the Native American tribes that they were fighting. This unchecked slaughter of an animal that was so important to the natives, both physically and spiritually, was devastating. The lives and livelihoods of the Plains tribes were forever altered. In the 1830s, there were 60 to 70 million bison in North America. Only 50 years later, only about 1,000 animals remained. Today, efforts are being made to restore the bison to the wild. There are now about 350,000 bison in the wild and captivity in North America. While these efforts may be encouraging, it is unlikely that the full glory of the bison herd and the tribes that depended upon them will ever be recaptured.